But the question that I got to be asked was this: what has the president done and what can he do about it? Mm-hmm. And I think that's an important question. I do not think anybody sitting here or anywhere in the Republic can pretend that there is no corruption in this country. There is a lot of corruption, and it is rampant, and something has to be done about it. And the thinking of the new constitution, when it created all these institutions, was that this would be an easier way of removing the power from the center, so that there is no protectionism, mm-hmm. and issues of corruption and those kind of issues can be dealt with at that devolved level. But the truth of the matter, like Dr. Awiti says, is that corruption has been devolved to the counties. And we have an anti-corruption commission, for instance. The law provides clearly that there should be lifestyle audits on anybody. Mm. And this should be done and can be done at random. When you talk about the NYS, for instance, and what Parliament has done about it, when you talk about corruption within Parliament itself, mm-hmm. who is supposed to deal with it? How can the President control Parliament, which is an independent institution? It should have its own mechanisms, and these are national mechanisms, where people are arrested and they are taken to a court of law after investigation. But then what control does the president have on the judiciary? The days are finished, and I would like to say this clearly. The days are finished when the president could pick a phone and call the Chief Justice, okay. or a judge dealing with a matter and tell him, I want that person jailed for 7 years, or I want so and so detained. Those days are gone. But look at an issue, for instance, about these audits, lifestyle audits. Mm-hmm. What is so difficult about the EACC picking a person like Kembi Gitura and telling them, the same way the KRA does an in-depth on a person, mm-hmm. tell you we want to do at random, you know, a lifestyle audit on you. I want to know, as you put a so collective on, I want to know, how is it that now you have a helicopter and 2 years ago you are a pauper?